While the 1900 marked Alpha's first foray into serious production, it's the smaller Giulietta that transformed Alfa Romeo into Italy's second largest automaker, overtaking a struggling Lancia. Its development wasn't trouble-free, though. The Giulietta Saloon's launch had to be delayed due to a resonance issue within the body shell, whose root cause proved elusive. Few people know that part of the Giulietta's development was funded through a public subscription of capital, with the expressed commitment to put the new model on sale by 1954. To attract savers to the investment, a lottery to win a car was set up as well. This meant Alfa Romeo had to have a car on time for the Touring Motor Show in April of 54, no matter what. Thankfully, the Austrian engineer Rudolf Huska reasoned that sports car buyers would tolerate higher noise levels in the cabin and that Nuccio Bertone could deliver a sexy coupé in record time. And that's how we got the fabulous Giulietta Sprint. The Sprint gathered about 500 orders within the Touring Motor Show's first day, thus buying Alfa's engineers the time they needed to get the four-door saloon ready for a 1955 release. The Giulietta was a massively overspecified vehicle given its target market. Powered by a 1290cc all-aluminum twin overhead cam inline four-cylinders engine, the small Alfa used aluminum castings for the gearbox, differential, and even the brake drums. The latter had helicoidal fins to further improve heat dissipation. By the time the sportier Giulietta Ti was introduced in 1957, Alfa Romeo's yearly output had increased 187%, but the best was yet to come. The Giulietta Ti adopted a slightly different rear-end design, with small, pointy tail fins partly concealing the taillights. But, much more importantly, it came with 65 horsepower, thanks to a higher compression ratio and a double-choke Solex carburetor. Enough to push the Giulietta Ti over 150 km per hour, which doesn't seem like much today, but was almost unheard of for your average 1950s family saloon. This lovely example from 1958, painted in azzurro acqua di fonte, belongs to our friends at the Portello factory. Like most of their cars, it has been extensively campaigned in various racing venues, including the Goodwood Revival. However, it's now presented as a road-going car ready for regularity events and even comes with a vintage mechanical tripmaster. Apart from its history and provenance, another point of particular interest of this Giulietta Ti is the relative rarity of its body style nowadays, as it lasted just 2 years in production. By 1959, the Giulietta Berlina and the Ti saw their front and rear fenders remodeled, with new headlights and taillights, new front air intakes, and a new dashboard inside. By 1961, when the Giulietta saloon body was again modified, with larger bonnet and boot openings, new bumpers, new front grille and taillight clusters, the faster Ti accounted for the vast majority of Giulietta sales, leading to the base model's discontinuation after the 1962 model year. Meanwhile, power output for the two Giulietta models had increased to 62 and 74 horsepower, respectively. The Giulietta Ti sold the red on until 1964, when the new Giulia 1300 took its place. But that's a story for another time. This 1958 Giulietta Ti is currently for sale from our friends at the Portello factory. If you are interested, please feel free to contact them at the addresses appearing on your screen right now. And if you want to see more cool classic Alfa Romeos, I think either one of the two videos appearing on your screen right now won't disappoint you. Check them out! and see you next week.